Hello and welcome to another CSD Fantasy YouTube video. This is the third video in the Team Score Projection series featuring the Dallas Cowboys. Remember to leave a like and comment below if you liked the video. The players I would take a look at today are Dak Prescott, Ezekiel Eliott, Dez Bryant, Cole Beasley, and Jason Witten. Since the Cowboys drafted light on the offensive side and have a pretty solid core group, I will not project opportunities for rookies. All projections are based on 16 games and full health. Now, let's dig in.
Dez against Josh at the bottom of the screen, and Prescott steps through and fires. Pass is caught.
Starting off, I will show you the opportunity pool that the players will have to share. I have analyzed all of their 2017 opponents' defenses over the last 2 years and put together how many pass attempts and rush attempts they will give up and put that in relation to the Cowboys' trends from the last 3 years. With this, the Dallas Cowboys will pass the ball 581 times and run it 437. Dividing this up from the trends, we get a target share and a share of carries, where we see a clear dominance for the number one running back, while the number one receiver has the second guy and tight end close behind.
It's Eliott! Eliott! For the touchdown! No flags! Cowboys lead!
What can you say about Dak that has not yet been said? Well, I can say that he will draw back 581 times next year while getting sacked or spiking the ball around 26 times. He will run the ball 50 times, and these 50 include kneel downs. From these opportunities, he will score 290.6 fantasy points in total, which is 4 more than last year. And the reason this number isn't higher is because of an increased number of interceptions.
This is head. Prescott keeps looking for Witten. Gonna run and score. Touchdown, Dallas.
Not sure that you can feed Zeke more without running him into the ground, but I sure do hope so. I have him pegged for 316 rush attempts in 2017, which is actually 6 less than last year, and this has a lot to do with the harder schedule, which impacts these trends. He will, however, get more targets with 62 and catch 50 of those. These runs and receptions will land him almost 14 more fantasy points than last year and raise his value in PPR.
Team setting up a screen for Eliott with blocking. Huge play. Eliott into Steeler territory. Down the sideline. And in for the touchdown. No flags. Throw up that X.
When I got asked who my favorite player in the NFL was, my answer was Dez. He just has that it factor and mentality that I love to see in an athlete. If he can stay healthy, I project him to get 130 targets, but since his targets are usually pretty difficult ones, I have him down for only 72 receptions. With his target share and production ability, I project him to score 169.9 fantasy points, which would be his 4th best fantasy season in his career. Not too good, and not too bad.
There's the fade, and it's caught for the touchdown by Dez Bryant!
Cole Beasley was sneakily the Cowboys' number one receiver last year with Dez out. I have him in these projections as the Cowboys' number two receiver, and with that, I project him to get 100 targets. With his crazy catch rate, I projected him to catch 74 of those. He will, however, only improve from last year's 114 points to 117. That is only a 3-point increase. But he has an incredibly low variance, so if you're looking for a guy to fill out a roster spot for a safe couple of points every week, he's definitely your guy.
Pocket. Prescott throws. Caught for the touchdown. Cole Beasley sneaks in.
Now I have a question for y'all. What is more durable, an old Nokia phone or Jason Witten? You tell me. I project Witten to still be the number one guy in Dallas next year, and with that, he will surpass 100 targets. And with his reliability, he will land on 82 receptions and score the more than adequate 101.3 fantasy points.
In the backfield, Prescott, Eliott got knocked down, throws wide open, Jason Witten to win the game.
To summarize it all, I like to take their 2017 projections and compare it to last year to see where they would have finished. Dak and Zeke's fantasy projection actually would not have moved their positional finishes from last year, while Dez would have jumped up 21 spots. Beasley would have been pushed down 1 spot from last year, and Witten down 3. I of course believe that all of these players are extremely draftable with almost the exact draft capital as last year. The one that I see getting overpaid for the most is Dak, while Dez might be undervalued. I would keep a close look at Dez's ADP over the next couple of months to decide how I feel about him with this projection, and the same goes with Dak.
The only thing else I got to say is, how about them Cowboys? Yeah!
Thank you very much for watching. Please leave a like and subscribe. Everything is very much appreciated. If you have questions about the numbers behind the projections, leave a comment below and I will get back to you. Check out Twitter for more charts and numbers, or go to csdfantasy.com for more fantasy numbers such as the Washington Redskins score projection. And as always, the spreadsheets are dark and full of terror.